We're going to cover how to run a one-proportion hypothesis test and calculate a one-proportion confidence interval using a Casio fx-9750 calculator in the context of an example. Suppose we are interested in determining whether more or fewer than 50% of Americans approved of the job the U.S. Supreme Court was doing. We could summarize this as a hypothesis test. The null hypothesis is that the approval rating is 50%, and the alternative hypothesis is that the approval rating is different than 50%. We use a significance level of alpha equals 0.05. According to a July 2014 Gallup poll, 47% of American adults approved of the job the Supreme Court was doing. The sample included data on 1,013 adults. Our two summaries here are the sample size of 1,013 adults and a sample proportion of 0.47, which means we had 1,013 times 0.47, or about 476 people in the sample say that they approved of the job the Supreme Court was doing. We verified the conditions for the sample are satisfied so that we can move ahead and conduct a hypothesis test. To conduct a one-proportion hypothesis test on the calculator, go to Menu, Navigate to Stat, hit F3 to open the Tests section. For proportions, we'll use a z-test, so hit F1. And finally, choose 1p for one-proportion hypothesis test. Now we must specify the details of our hypothesis test. Looking at our hypotheses, note that the null value is 0.5, and it's two-sided, so we make sure that we have a not equals sign here. If we had needed to change to a different-sided test, we could have used the keys F1, F2, or F3. Here we'll need to change the p-naught to 0.5 and hit execute. We also need to specify how many people's responses aligned with the category we are interested in, approval, which is 476 people in our sample. Finally, we specify the sample size, which was 1,013 adults. Once we've entered the data, we can hit execute one more time to get the results of the hypothesis test. The results show us several pieces of information. We have an alternative hypothesis of p-naught equals 0.5, our z-test statistic is negative 1.917, the test's p-value is 0.055, the sample proportion is 0.47, and the sample size is 1,013. Because the p-value is larger than alpha, we do not reject the null hypothesis. That is, we don't have strong evidence to conclude the approval rating is different than 50%. Now when I'm done, I can exit out to the main stat page. Suppose we had been interested in constructing a 95% confidence interval for the data instead of the hypothesis test for the data. To do so, go to Enter for confidence interval. Choose Z since we're working with proportions, and choose 1p for one proportion confidence interval. Next, enter the confidence level of interest. We'll use 95% and then enter our data. The calculator has, conveniently for us, already copied over the data summary from the hypothesis test. We can execute to get the interval. Here's the left side of the interval, the right side, the center of the interval, which is also our sample proportion, and the sample size. So now we can write that we are 95% confident that the true proportion of U.S. adults who approve of the job the Supreme Court is doing is between 43.9% and 50.1%. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up below and subscribe to our channel.